Hello friends, in this video we will explain the basic components of an FM radio receiver circuit in the form of a block diagram and the flow of information in the system. We will also explain if a user wants to select 93.5 FM radio frequency, then which components of the radio receiver will he use to achieve the purpose.
Frequency modulation. In telecommunications and signal processing, the frequency modulation or FM is the encoding of information in a carrier wave by varying the instantaneous frequency of the wave. In analog frequency modulation, such as FM radio broadcasting of an audio signal representing a voice or a music, the instantaneous frequency deviation, the difference between the frequency of the carrier and its center frequency, is proportional to the modulating signal.
Now we will see the block diagram for FM radio receiver circuit. First we have the antenna. Antenna tags the signal that are present in the space around it and passes them to the circuit.
The next is the pre-select filter. This part of the receiver circuit helps in removing the FM part from the input signal and discards the rest of it. It then further sends only the FM part for processing.
Next we have the low noise amplifier. This part of the circuit amplifies the signal.
The mixer and oscillator are the main components of the receiver circuit. This is because it helps in getting the desired frequency signal from the band of frequencies that had been intercepted. We tune the oscillator in such a way that after its superposition with the received signal, it is easy to get the desired frequency signal from the received.
We have then the intermediate frequency filter. It basically down-converts the spectrum of frequency modulation band.
The demodulator. This helps in converting the electrical signals to audio signals.
And at the end, we have the audio amplifier. The demodulated signal is passed on to the audio amplifier and then to the speaker.
Now, let us look at the circuit itself.
The antenna captures the signal from the surrounding and passes them to the circuit for further processing.
So, after receiving the input signals from the antenna, the user tunes the resonant frequency of the LC oscillating circuit so that the mixing of which with the input signals produces the waves of the desired frequency along with waves of other frequencies too. Also, the BJTs in the circuit are used for amplifying the signals so that information is not lost during the other functions of the circuit. The RC circuit made up of rheostat then is tuned by the user to ensure that only the waves of the desired frequency are allowed to pass through. Now, the signals consist of the waves of the desired frequency, which are amplified using the op-amp by a factor as high as 100%.
As now we have amplified the required signal, so even the noises get amplified. Now to remove the noises, we have provided capacitors attached in parallel. This greatly helps in removing the noises. The battery of 4.5 volts provided has been attached as its VCC and is used to power up the op-amp.
So now, if a user wants to relax while listening to 93.5 FM, there are two tunings that he needs to set in order to be able to enjoy the FM. Firstly, he needs to set an appropriate resonant frequency of the LC oscillator, and secondly, he also needs to tune the rheostat so that the RC part of that circuit allows only the waves of the desired frequency to pass through. Now, let us understand this using an example. Consider that the frequency corresponding to 93.5 MHz radio bands in air is, let's say, 50 MHz. Now, then the user needs to tune the LC oscillator to have a resonant frequency of 43.5 MHz. And he also needs to tune the rheostat so that the RC circuit allows waves of 93.5 MHz to pass through. In the more sophisticated radio receivers, since the tuning of the LC and RC part of the circuit is dependent on each other and is related, the user is only meant to tune one of them, and the second part of the tuning is taken care of by the architecture of the circuit. So, this is it about FM receivers. Hope you found it informative and enjoyed it.